We will move on to the next paper, OP37, Randomized Control Trial Investigating the Effectiveness of Cognitive Behavior Group Therapy Compared to a Waitlist Control in the Treatment of University Students with Social Phobia. Authors are A. Hapangama, B. G. R. De Silva, P. T. De Souza, K. A. L. A. Kuruppuarachchi, A. Ravindran, A. R. Vikramasinghe, and S. S. Williams. The paper will be read by A. Hapangama.
Thank you. So I'm going to present a study which we did on university students with social phobia, comparing the effectiveness of group cognitive behavior therapy versus a waitlist control. Social phobia or social anxiety disorder is characterized by the sufferer's persistent fear of negative evaluation, especially in a group setting. It is one of the most prevalent of all mental disorders. And because of the fact that it occurs during mid or late adolescence, it has a significant effect on the sufferer's secondary or tertiary education and their employability. If we don't detect and treat, which happens most of the time, it is known to run a chronic and unremitting course, leading to a high disease burden because their quality of life is low, their productivity is low, they use the services so much. They are very dependent financially. Not only that, the fact that social phobia is increasingly associated with depression and substance, especially alcohol and suicide, increases the morbidity and mortality. The available guidelines, such as the NICE, prescribe individual-based CBT as the first-line treatment. However, we know that individual CBT is very costly. And in a resource-scarce country like ours, we don't have enough number of trained therapists to deliver this therapy. So in this background, we thought a group-based CBT will be a more sort of a feasible option. So our objective was to determine the effectiveness of group-based CBT compared to a waitlist control in a cohort of university students with social phobia. We conducted a randomized control trial which ran for 8 weeks, where the rater was blind to the randomization. We used the Leibovitz Social Anxiety Scale, the Sinhala version, which we translated and validated some time back. And we also culturally adapted the Heimberg's group CBT module. And this was delivered by a trained clinical psychologist who was supervised by a consultant psychiatrist. Our inclusion criteria were the participants were registered students of either the University of Moratuwa or University of Kalania. They had to score 39 or more in the Leibovitz scale, and if they scored more than 39, they were again assessed for the DSM-4 criteria for social phobia by a consultant psychiatrist. However, if they were already on any form of psychotherapy or antidepressants, they were excluded. We enrolled 30 students, and using a computer-generated tool, we divided them into the group CBT arm and the waitlist arm. We had 15 in each arm with a mean age of 22. If you look at the results, you may see that except one person, everyone in the experimental group had improved scores in their Leibovitz scale. So if we convert into a repeat measure analysis, the CGBT arm had significant improvement in their Leibovitz scale scores at the end of 8 weeks, and the results remained the same when we controlled for age and gender. So in discussion, the culturally adapted CGBT was significantly effective when compared with the waitlist control, and this has been shown in other studies done in the West as well as some Asian countries like Japan and Iran. What is more important in our setting is now we still have a very holistic culture. So doing this form of therapy in the group format gives them a sense of belonging and also improves their social skills. The other thing is we know that stigma reduces these young people accessing services. So when it is done in a group setting, they get to know there are other people. My peers are also having the same disability, so this is an added advantage. The key strengths are, this is the first study to our knowledge to be done on this cohort of people using a cultural adapted format. We know that we use the self-reported scale and that participants were not blind, so this may have had an impact on the results. However, we found that the group CBT was superior to a weightless control, but we need to establish whether it is equivalent or more effective than individual CBT, because it's very important to treat these people, otherwise they will suffer. Thank you.
Thank you. The paper is now open for discussion.
As for the control, I'm just asking why a medication control was not used?
Because we had a lack of funds. And also it was difficult to control considering the resources we were having at the moment.
So when someone can ask, for example, you have deprived a set of patients during your trial a viable alternate treatment, which is antidepressants.
Generally, at the moment, the accepted first line in patients are CBT if their symptoms are not severe enough. So when we assessed them for the social phobia symptoms, we did offer them what they wanted, because sometimes we have to look at the patient's preference also. So however, because our aim was to determine group CBT versus weightless control, those who preferred medication were not included.
Any other questions from the audience?
Yes, ethical approval was obtained from the Faculty of Medicine, University of Kalanias, ERC, and we got permission from Vice Chancellors of both universities.
Thank you very much.